Hello and welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay. We've got a kind of a new one, one that I've already tried and a little bit excited about. It's kind of because it's do you know what? Let's get on with it instead of blah, 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 blah. I'm trying to do the honours and get these get these reviews kind of shifting a little bit and get them going a little bit. So let's have a little look what I've got. I've got do 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 do. Who's afraid of the big bad wolf? Now, big bad wolf. This is a kind of it's a Green King jobby. It's a big bad wolf. So Green King of in some people's eyes a big bad wolf. I like Green King. The only one I don't really go mad on is the IPA, the green one, the yellow one, the red one. You know, them kind of just a bit bland, you know. But they do a lot of other really gorgeous stuff under both Green King and their other kind of subsidiaries and things. And this is one of their subsidiaries. This is, just looking for me thing. This is the Metropolitan Brewing Company, and it's done in conjunction with Tesco's all across the UK. Not quite sure in how many different Tesco's. I think it's probably most of them, if not all of them. But anyway, I showed you the bottle already, didn't I? It's opened up nicely. That's what it looks like. It looks quite dignified. Let's have a little pop and see what's... Excuse his glasses. I don't look flash, do I? I know. Don't take the me. Don't take the Mickey. I nearly said the peeing. Digga 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 digga. I look like the what's his name? What's the rock guy? I can't think of his name. Anyway, Humulus blah blah blah, or Wolf of the Woods. Humulus lupulus. Yes, Wolf of the Woods. So Wolf. Anyway, Latin name for hops. Right, the rest of it, I didn't really want to know there. There you go. Anyway, it tells you what hops is in there. Centennial, Amarillo, Stewing, Goldings and Cascade. Now, I did want to know that. I do like to know that, but I wish they'd kind of put it in little sections or something like that. I'm not moaning, because I love knowing what the hops are in there. But I like to have a little guess and play at them. I like to kind of have a little game. Excuse me looking all like serious with the glasses, isn't it? That's the crown there. The old M for Metropolitan. Not sure why it's Metropolitan, but there you go. So let's pour this and see what we've got going on. Water, malted barley, carbon dioxide, sugar syrup. Sugar syrup. Hops. Right, 6% ABV. Not quite sure the idea of the sugar syrup. But there you go. Anyway, it doesn't say anything else. So let's give it a go, let's see how we go. I've tried three of these already, the three different flavours. And I've enjoyed them. But I've got a few things to say. So let's go for this. Let's have a little take the bleeding things off. Right, let's have a little go and so I can tell you about it. Now it looks lovely, crisp, clean and neat and even and everything, you know. I can stir a little bit of a head into it if I want to. Nice bit of carbonation. Gentle, lovely. It's kind of nicely carbonated. It's not going, yeah, like that. It's false carbonated, you know, but it's nicely carbonated. So I like that so far. It's the head's dying down. I like that as well. I don't want a big fluffy head to stay there like for 20 years, even after the drink's gone. And it's still on the glass like that. You go chiseling at it and everything. Right, so let's have a little taster. Let's have a little smell. Now it smells very nice. There's a slight lemonade smell in there. You're not getting massively punchy with those hops, and it's, I believe it's dry hopped with them. But they're not massively punchy, but you got a nice little Goldings there. He's earthing it down really beautifully. That is really nice. He's earthing those big fruity and spicy notes and everything else. And he's earthing them down and holding on to them, putting a little bit of spicy peppers and things on there as well. But that's nice, really nice smell. Let's just get a few more aromas quickly. Those little Sharon fruits, you got a little bit of kind of almost a tomato note in there, like a sweet, sweet tomato. You know when you get cherry tomatoes, a little notes of them, you're getting little notes of like the old belly buttony navel oranges, like that blood orange sort of notes in there, sort of a darker sort of orange notes, and a bit of like a lemonade, that's kind of sugary lemonade, and I think that's the sugar coming out, and it's taking over any of your sharper notes and kind of, yeah, you know, anyway, let's have a taste. It's lovely. It's really lovely. But, and this is the kind of the thing that I was wanting to bring to the attention of people tasting it. It is really lovely, but there's a little note in there that reminds you of shandy. And it's because those sugars in there, when you've drunk shandy a few times, those sugars, those kind of, you know, processed sugars, they've kind of they sweeten the drink, but they give it a certain flavour to them, and that, you know. And then once you've tried that, and whenever you try beer with anything sugary with it, it's like reminds you of shandy. And it reminds me of shandy. It's got that sugary note in there. There's a lovely bitterness coming off that styrian. Really lovely bitterness. That is beautiful, kind of lovely bitterness there. That dries it in. Nice, almost a chalky, kind of dry bitterness that comes in and just calls for more then. But it's slightly ruined with the sugar a little bit, you know. I don't mean to say that it's kind of cutting corners or trying to add with cheaper ingredients and things like that, because it's still a fine drink. I don't know how to kind of word this, because it's not a horrible drink. I don't think it's kind of the, you know, doing the evils that some drinks do and things like that, but it's, I always think, if you're putting sugar in a beer, you should only be putting sugar in beer really to pump it up there to the sort of eights and nines and things like that, like the Belgian ones and candy sugar and whatever. Pardon me. But it is still a good beer, but not too sure about the sugar. It's the head is completely dyed. Carbonation, I think some people may find that as an issue. I like carbonation to die, but I like it to die a little bit slower. It's like, whoosh, gone, you know. Let's just give it a twirl in there, see what happens. See how quickly it does twirl out, go out. Now, that's the carbonation. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. It's almost gone. Just some big kaplunky bubbles. About 20 seconds and you've killed your head already. Yeah, look, it's gone, all pretty much gone. So maybe a bit of wheat in there or something like that, just to hold it on. But it's still carbonated, it's still perky on the tongue. Let's give it another taste. The Goldings and Amarillo are a bit covered up with the sugars now. You're not getting them fruity notes because they've become like overcooked jam or something like that. It's like too jam with too much sugar in or something. It's just, you know. And it's not particularly a sweet beer, you know. It's a little bit sweet, but it's not particularly sweet. It's just the fruity, any sharpness in the fruit, which you need for a fruit, you need that sharpness. Any sharpness in the fruit at all, even in things like peaches and that, you've still got a little bit of acidity in it. That's been masked completely in a kind of lemonade sugarness. Any little lemony edges are, you know, so yeah, you know, it's a nice one, but you know, dun 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 dun. You let me know. I think you let me know, you guys out there, what you think. Because I'm on two sides of the fence with it, and it's quite uncomfortable, because one side's going that way in quite a long way, and the other side's going that way in quite a long way, and the middle way's like, you know. Let me know what you think. Personally, it's alright, but it's leaving the gum in the back of my throat of sugar, and I don't think I'd buy it again. So, cheers, bottoms up, chin chin. Take care of yourselves, take care of each other. See you in the next one. Don't be late. Oh, I will start without you. With